We're going to celebrate Black History Month today with a legend who is very much alive, and she is making sure that other kids, and especially girls, are going to have the best life possible. We have Jackie Joyner Kersey, Olympic track and field gold medalist, East St. Louis native. Let's first go back to your childhood and just about growing up in East St. Louis and your love of the city.
You know, growing up in East St. Louis, that's home. And when I was a little girl, I, you know, just wanted to make my parents proud. Didn't know I had this, eventually, this athletic gift that would allow me to travel the world. But wherever my travels would take me, I always wanted people to know that I was from East St. Louis, you know, on the Illinois side.
That's right. That's right. Represent home. The legendary coach Nino Fanoi was your coach. When did you decide that you wanted to run track as a career?
You know, I started running at the age of 9. I finished last in my first competition.
Aww.
Yeah. And so, but it wasn't about where I finished. You know, I recognized 4 through 8, 4 through 9 was always on the grass, and 1, 2, 3 was always on the podium. And I said to myself, I have to work a little harder and start getting on the podium, because 1, 2, 3 usually are selected to make national teams, eventually Olympic teams. And it wasn't until I was 14 when I saw the 76 Olympic Games on television, and I saw girls doing what I was trying to do, and I said, maybe one day I could go to the Olympics.
So how old were you when you did make it to the Olympics?
I went to my first Olympic trials when I was 18, and then I made my first team when I was 22.
Okay, so young, so young. But one thing you did have to battle your entire life was asthma. The asthma medication you were on at the time was considered a banned substance by the IOC. Yes. How did you cope? I mean, what did you do?
You know, I was very fortunate to work with a pulmonologist here, Dr. Bess. And at that time, I would do peak flow. I would blow in to see where my numbers were, and I was always below like 350, 400. You know, I was always trying to get to 700, but that wasn't to be. But I would make sure that my game plan was staying on top of my medication, because at the time, we would do unannounced testing. But there were long-acting medicine that I had to take, and that I had to have a notice on file with the USOC, so when they randomly test me, that would show up, you know, in my sample. But when I went to competition, if I was on prednisone or anything like that, I just wouldn't compete, because that would give me a positive test.
Okay. Wow. Yes. You just really had to work around that one.
Gosh, yes.
After your career, you embarked on another career of helping young people, opening the JJK Center back at home.
Yes.
In East St. Louis on the Illinois side. What do you want the kids at the JJK Center to know? What do you want for them?
You know, being able to have the JJK Center, you know, we offer after-school programs. You know, we use sports as a hook to get them in there. We have my Winning in Life program, where it's character and leadership development, trying to thread throughout our program the different principles, like critical thinking, you know, giving them, letting them have determination and grit. You know, also learning about service and values. And to me, hopefully, they can walk through those doors, you know, see a smiling face, go into the computer labs, work on, do their homework, then go do some activity. But through it all, I want them to be great human beings. And when they leave the JJK Center and wherever their travels may take them, that they too will come back to the community and also try to reach one and help teach one.
All right, well, let's go ahead and get some children, especially some girls, in class, shall we? We have the Women and Girls in Sports Day at the Jackie Joyner Kersey Center. That's actually today from 4 until 6. It's for students grades 5 through 12, girls age, or grades 5 through 12, 101 Jackie Joyner Kersey Circle in East St. Louis. For more information, go to jjkfoundation.org. Now, when we come back, we're going to go ahead and look back at the tape, and Jackie Joyner Kersey is going to tell me where I went wrong when I tried to run track, here on the 9 a.m. show.